Hello, I'm Miss Heartless Girl, and today I will be giving you an overview of a first-time convention goer's trip to Ohayocon. In this video, I will be giving you an overview of my opinions, my thoughts, and what I experienced, but it will hopefully give first-time goers to this con an idea of what to expect, because I honestly went in not knowing what to expect. So I'll be talking about parking, hotels, food, photography, cosplayers, all sorts of stuff. Now, let me preface this by saying no con should be held in the winter, especially in the East Coast and Midwest. Let's just all agree. Especially when there's a polar vortex, snowpocalypse, whatever going on. Because if you're going to die trying to go to a con, it's just a bad idea. It just shouldn't be happening. Granted, now, most cons in the winter like are to save us from the boredom, so we're not like going crazy waiting for Colossal Con or something like that. But I digress. Now, I've heard about Ohayocon for years. I've been meaning to go, but it's hard as a student and as a Michigander to take time off and just go off to Ohio. But I was finally able to go this year, and to be honest, I was a bit disappointed. Now, the convention is held at the same place that Matsuri Con is held at, so I've been there before. But obviously, as a bigger con and a con in the winter, I didn't know what to really expect. Have to say, there was a lot of people, a lot of people. And because of the snow, you're a lot more limited to what you can, where you can shoot and kind of what cosplays you can bring. I was super smart and I brought Sailor Mars, and I mean, it was snowing, so obviously I knew what I was doing. But I was very fortunate to have been able to hang out with some of my friends, to meet some really fantastic cosplayers, shoot them, meet some fantastic cosplay photographers and network with them. And I have to say, that's one of the biggest things of this con was honestly just because there's so many people, you can get to meet a lot and network with a lot of different people. Now, because the convention center is attached to a hotel, obviously, you really want to book with the hotel just for convenience that the convention center is attached to. However, the really nice thing is there's a lot of different hotels on the same street, not even a block away, that offer great deals for Ohayocon as well. I didn't even stay at the same convention center hotel. I was one across the street, and it was really nice. It worked out well, and despite it being cold, the travel wasn't that bad. Some of these hotels have, you know, complimentary breakfast. Can't complain too much about that. I know the Hyatt doesn't. Parking wise, there is obviously a parking garage in the hotel convention center, but not too far over, there's another parking lot. No coverings, unfortunately, but there's a lot more space. So when the first convention center parking filled up, obviously it's nearby. It cost me $30, I think, to park for the whole weekend. Food wise, there's a lot of different varieties of food. There's the bar at the hotel. Obviously, if you're going to want to drink there, 21 and over, but there is food sold there as well. It's obviously a little more expensive and a little more, you're not going to get as much bang for your buck. There's also a food court in the convention center that has a wide variety of food for all reasonable prices, such as Subway, there's a Chinese place, all sorts of stuff. So you can get a whole plate of food or a sub for like a few bucks and still have plenty to spend for the weekend, but you don't have to worry about starving yourself. The main problem is, though, obviously, lines. While there's a good amount of locations, there's still a lot of people, so you're still going to be waiting in line for a little while. Prepare for that. And for the most part, no, the public was cool. Staff, on the other hand, I wasn't too impressed with as a whole. My one friend brought a bow for a cosplay prop, and no arrows or anything, but she had to check it in, and the staff was like, nope, you can't do it because it's a real bow. It's a kid's bow. There's no arrows. But I could carry around my keyblades just fine, but I'm sure I just didn't get caught or something. Another thing is, some of the staff members weren't exactly super friendly, and the whole layout of the con was really, really weird. Like, there'd be lines for a panel, autographs, whatever, and they would go through the hall and then kind of continue across the walkway that people were walking through. I personally don't understand that system and how you know, well, what place in line am I? How far away? But that's how they had it. Personally, I don't think the system works. As a photographer, because it is winter, you're obviously more limited. With the weather we had this year, there was a lot of snow, and I think that limited a lot of shoots for a lot of people, unfortunately. However, if you're brave enough to face the cold, go for it. I think you get some really great shots. However, the inside really does give you a lot of options too. You just gotta be really creative, like I think these fellow photographers have. In using different lighting and obviously being careful on how you frame things, you can make one boring walled area make look like something truly amazing. It's all about the creativity there. My favorite area was probably this lighted pathway between one of the hotels and the convention center. However, when other people realized this, there was a lot of other cosplayers there. So I suggest planning accordingly, being considerate if other people are trying to shoot there, and of course trying to walk through as well. Don't want to block up the hallways, now do we? Panel-wise, I thought there was a nice diversity. There was fun stuff, and then there was scientific stuff, and you know, cosplay serious stuff. I only went to ones that my friends hosted, but I had a lot of fun, and I saw there was a nice variety for what was there. Another problem I had with the layout was the whole fact of you didn't know what was where, and there was no maps really given, and not even a real badge. It was one of those wristlet things. But the whole fact of, like, I was walking around trying to find places to shoot, and all of a sudden I'm up on the third floor, and it's like, nope, you can't come up here unless you have a badge because it's Artist Alley. Well, I didn't know that, so then I awkwardly had to go down a computer, down an elevator when I realized this because the other escalator was broken, or there wasn't one down, I can't remember. There wasn't a lot of seating either. Of course, they're seating at the bar, but that kind of fills up quickly because people are cycling through. There weren't really many benches or anything, so if you're tired, it's harder to find seats unless you want to sit on that big stairway, but I feel like that's kind of more an occupational hazard to sit there for everybody because it's a kind of cool place to shoot, and then you can't shoot there. And then the whole fact of, like, it's stairs, so, you know, if you trip and fall, you're going to roll over and knock over a bunch of people, like bowling or dominoes or whatever. Overall, the con just kind of had a very blah feel. It was more people hanging out. It didn't feel much like an actual anime convention to me that was really exciting and put me in the mood. By the midday Saturday, I was just kind of like, it's all right. However, that doesn't mean I probably won't go back again, as it was enjoyable, and a lot of my friends go there, but I don't think it's going to be one I actively seek out in the future unless some things change. Whether it's programming, the layout, maybe the location. However, I think the location's all right. I'm not sure. Something to decide in the future. But obviously, spending-wise, you're not gonna spend a lot of money on food, at least, if you plan accordingly. Dress warmly. Dress warmly. You don't wanna die or get hypothermia. That would be very bad. Overall, it's a cool con to check out if you're looking for something bigger, but if you're looking for something like really structured, might not be the best one. Then again, this is my opinions as a first-time goer. I'd recommend bringing a group of friends as well. I had more fun when I had people to walk around with. Though I'm sure you'll meet plenty of wonderful people there as well. Now, I hope this video was helpful to you as a first-time goer or as a repeated goer looking just for a different eye view from an outsider. Thank you for watching.